zero.
Roger, Jim, what's the report?
The flight director says get back in.
Okay. Back in? Back in.
Roger, we're just trying to talk to you.
Who are you? You good enough to eat?
In the name of Anna, the all-maceful, the ever-living, the bringer of plurabilities, haloed be her eve, her sing-time song, her riddle be run unhemmed as it is on Eva.
Some of them look pretty good in them.
We have already reached a point where remedial control, born out of knowledge of media and their total effects on all of us, must be exerted.
Number three, take
right.
Two.
This is McLuhan, number three, take two.
Three.
Take three.
This is.
Number two? All right, number two. We call the other one number two. All right, number two, take three.
How shall the new environment be programmed now that we have become so involved with each other, now that all of us have become the unwitting workforce for social change?
You never knew what was coming next.
With kiss, 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 cross, cross, kiss, cross.
We are only beginning to realize what a tiny slice of human possibility we now educate. The total environment is now the great teacher. Training will be more concerned with training the senses and perceptions than with stuffing brains. Studies show a high correlation between sensory bodily development, now largely neglected, and intelligence. There's a world of difference between the modern home environment of integrated electric information and the classroom.
Britain formally applies for membership in the market. Westmoreland gets control of the pacification program in Vietnam.
We have no art. We do everything as well as we can.
A strange bond often exists among antisocial types in their power to see environments as they really are. The poet, the artist, whoever sharpens our perception tends to be antisocial, rarely well adjusted. He cannot go along with currents and trends.
People who think that because
when my act first
he's
got
on, television
I had offered every major publishing house to do a book on
well,
anything at all.
Sing for themselves.
That's not
that
writing.
We really need
that's exploiting.
Whatever footnotes derived from the visual arts, from graphic arts, from sound, from music.
The artist, the enema of society, points out things that many people would prefer not to notice. Art is anything you can get away with.
The envelope, please.
Next is my page 19, speech 1, innumerable confusion.
I don't think you can quite get away with that phrase. Innumerable is suggests numbers. Confusion is singular. I don't know. Do you like the phrase, innumerable confusion?
Innumerable confusion.
Well, it's part of it.
It's part of what?
It's part of the confusion.
Ah, okay. You're miming.
Miming over that.
Yeah. Innumerable confusion and a profound feeling of despair invariably emerge in periods of great technological and cultural traditions such as our own. Our age of anxiety is in great part the result of trying to do today's job with yesterday's tools, with yesterday's concepts, with yesterday's ideals.
And now, a word from our sponsor.
Speak that I may see you.
No, Evelyn. Don't try to stop me.
The young person today is a data processor on a very large scale.
Can't desert them now, Evelyn. As much as I love
them. The end and the beginning were always there. Before the beginning and after the end.
Desire is there as in time, my dear, but I must pull myself from your arms.
Don't, darling.
Duty.
Sheep who die silently are no use as victims.
Nose counting, a cherished part of the 18th century fragmentation process, has rapidly become a cumbersome and ineffectual form of social assessment in an environment of instant electric speech. The public, in the sense of a great consensus of separate and distinct viewpoints, is finished.
I must have been delirious, for I even sought amusement in speculating upon the relative velocities of their several descents toward the foam below.
Unhappily, we confront this new situation with an enormous backlog of outdated mental and psychological responses. The new electric drama has left us dangling. Our most impressive words and thoughts betray us. They refer us only to the past, not to the present.
A mother, father, two children, and an anthropologist.
What's the definition of an Eskimo family?
Now the world's a sage, Marvin.
We are back once more.
I've discovered
in the age of the hunter.
Kind of massage, but you need two.
This time the hunter is a fact finder and a researcher.
And what
a discoverer.
You do with them.
In the study of ideas, it is necessary to remember that insistence on hard-headed clarity is
together
from
sequentially,
feeling,
but not necessarily
a mist,
in just one straight line across a wall.
Insistence on clarity at all costs is based on sheer superstition as to the mode in which human intelligence functions. Our reasonings grasp at straws, the premises float on gossamers.
And then if you hang it up,
the meaning of meaning.
The young today reject goals.
Is meaning.
The young want rules.
We shape our tools and thereafter our tools shape us.
Today's child is growing up absurd because he lives in two worlds. And neither of them inclines him to grow up.
Compartmentalization of occupation.
Yeah, I know. Learning, the educational process, has long been associated only with the glum,